He is an ordinary person. He is not like Haridas Thakur or others. So he should have a bona fide guru. Without bona fide guru, he cannot have the relation of Krishna in Braja. If a man chanting his Bharata 64 rounds, even and so doing Bhadhutri, no sleeping, nothing, but he will not go to Vrindavan. If he is initiated even, he will not go. By mind, by body, he should be in Vrindavan. And he should be a really properly initiated. Having Siksha Guru, Diksha Guru. If not, Diksha Guru will do the work of Siksha Guru. And Siksha Guru will do the work of that. Go qualified SU Association. So much
progressed.
So, any kind you have. Some appellants, some shishya, some admirers, money, but not Prabhupada. You may go to Vaikunth even, but after Diksha, like Ajami. He was initiated by four Vaishnavas. By their association, he received so much good knowledge and tatpurya. And then he went to Haridwar and he practiced, then he advanced. Anything? What you are?
Question.
So many questions.
So many questions.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's appropriate. What about
Achyam, you should think in the meantime.
The devotees are experienced here in the West is a confusion about Harinam and Diksha. They seem more important than Diksha than Harinam. But I say this, Harinam is more important than Diksha.
Harinam is more important than
Diksha. Yes.
Diksha mantra. Not Diksha.
Diksha mantra.
Diksha mantra. Harinam is more important.
Yes.
And superior.
Yes.
These mantras give only relationship.
Mm-hmm.
And they can cut off all these nonsense things they have,
yes.
All kinds of anartha and all others.
Mm-hmm. So,
but Harinam is himself Krishna.
Krishna.
No?
Mm-hmm.
And Radhika both.
Mm-hmm.
To clarify, to have a relation and to have Braja power, Gurudev gives that. But they will not go to Braja. They will on the door of Braja or even on the door of Vaikunth, we will have to give up all these months and everything.
So when we take Diksha,
but name we can go with us in Braja and Samsat there also Hare Krishna. Remembering, dancing, singing there, because Krishna is himself. No bhed,
no difference.
Nama Chintamani, Krishna Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha. So it is superior than months. But even essential it is today, initiation, because these. Without this, we cannot have any relation to Krishna. It will not come Vatsalya Bhav or Sakha Bhav, especially Madhu Bhav.
So, the diksha we get a mantra. Huh? And actually, the Shiloh Shidhavan.
Mantra of Krishna.
Yes.
Sambandha Gyan.
That
we cannot chant mantra in Golok Vrindavan.
But Srila Prabhupada said this mantra exoterically can take you to Swargaloka.
Swargaloka.
But esoterically, Vaishnava mantra and all the mantras take you also to Golok Vrindavan.
But yet, we have read Bhagavatamrita. That recitations of mantra has stopped at the door of Vaikuntha.
Mm-hmm.
Only that mood, essence of that mantra,
mm-hmm.
that I am, Krishna is my Bhagavan.
Mm-hmm.
Only this, but not swaha, 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 no.
Because
Vaikuntha is the mother of the Vedas, is secret in Vaikuntha.
But name is more important. Yes.
Because he is Krishna.
Yes.
To progress, to have a relation with name, to have a darshan of Krishna and prajipava, mantra essential. Krishna mantra haita hai sansar mocha, a Krishna naam haite pai Krishna prema dhan.
Isme na charan.
Sansar mocha. Sansar mocha means?
Stop this cycle of birth and death.
Yes. And Krishna naam haite pai Krishna prem.
Krishna naam is Krishna prem.
Though naam and mantra are same, but by nama, in the end, or swaha, and in the beginning, they are reading, playing, playing, saying, om. Krishna naam, by these adding some power to go beyond birth and death comes, and our pure naam comes. This adds, but it gives a mood that he is my Bhagavan, he is Bhuti Bhagavan, Anangaya, Prachodaya. It will come back. But with Krishna, naam is Krishna, relationship giving this much. Sridhar Maharaj is telling truth. We'll have to reconcile it.
Maharaj, I heard Sridhar Maharaj say exactly the same thing you're saying.
Yes, I know.
He's not saying the Gayatri Mantra takes to.
He says one explanation that it takes you to Swargaloka.
Try to reconcile all this. He has told true to accident.
And he gave a circle, Maharaj.
Good explanation. Good explanation.
But
that by chanting Brahma Vakshi take you only to Swargaloka, and by chanting Mahamantra take you to Goloka Vrindavan.
I have read in Brihad Bhagavatamrita and all other scriptures. Brahma Gayatri, chanting, turns into Kama Gayatri. No difference at all. Bharga Devasya, what is the meaning? Who is Dev?
Krishna.
Bharga? Power. Srimati Radhika is there. It is covered there. Brahma
opens
in and she becomes like Ananga and Krishna Ananga Deva.
Yeah, this
Siddharth Pujapashita Maharaj has get explanation in his slopes.
Yes.
Very beautiful. I was searching anything, but I give explanation. But I saw and became happy that, oh, in this slope he has given all these things that I explained. So I became more happy. None has written or like this. Or Goswami, Rupa Goswami, especially Jiva Goswami, from Agni Puran, he has given explanation. Sometimes we cannot understand the views of realized person. That is the difference. We think that I understand, but it may be that again you will hear, again you will see that I have gained something. Again, again. Hare Krishna is more important than that.
Mm-hmm.
It has so many modes of Vrindavan. Hare Krishna, meeting.
Mm-hmm.
Krishna, Krishna, Hare, separation.
Mm-hmm.
In Valli, Radhe Krishna, no separation, no all these things. There are not so many vilas in that. Each letter of Hare Krishna has so many deep meanings and full of oceans of rush. I have same doubt as you have. But my doubt finished. I used to tell Radhe Krishna is Radhe Krishna. Hearing some Sahaja Baba. And I receive the, all the meanings and rush in the words of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur and especially of Raghunath Das Goswami. When the Hari Nam Chintamani you can see. All very, very full of a rush. So take the Namaha Buddha this time. You to become. Hare Krishna, and beating, testing with Raya Ramananda. Rig-Ved cannot touch. It cannot touch. It can do like that.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, let's put the other way. Rama Krishna, they start with Ram.
Anyhow, this name is superior than any. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu discussed Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
আপনি
পাশে দেরি করেন না জল খাওয়ার জন্য আমার লিখাতে হবে
বললেই তো তাও তো না রাগ করবে
রাগ কোথায় করছি
বললেই তো হবে এত সরল সহজ ভাবে একটু সরল সিধা হও
সরল সিধা কেন কখন তো বলছি চলুন কেন বসে থাকা সারা দিন বসেই থাকবে যে তো কোনো কাজ নাই
Anger comes on the nose of Nami.
Disappeared.
Oh,
To preach, propagate and preach, and to help all the devotees, newly devotees. So you should try to come and preach there also. and help them to be more conscious, Krishna consciousness.
Prabhupada also sings this song and gives a very nice purport that the lotus feet of Lord Nityananda are as cooling as moon rays multiplied by millions of times. Somebody may be working in a very hot summer in some factory or very hot and suffering situation, but if they come out in the evening in the moonshine, they feel so much relief. So if you take that relief and multiply it by millions of times, and more than that is the relief from taking shelter of the lotus feet of Lord Nityananda, from the samsara, the burning fire of the samsara, the cycle of birth and death. Without having taken shelter of the lotus feet of Nityananda, this is a song by Narottam Das Thakur, without having taken shelter of the lotus feet of Nityananda, one cannot approach Radha and Krishna. Nityananda is Lord Balaram himself, and Nityananda is Akanda Guru Tattva. That means that he is complete Guru, the truth of Guru, he is complete. And all bona fide spiritual masters are manifestations of him. So he is Krishna himself manifesting as Guru to teach us how to serve Krishna. And without taking shelter of Guru, we know that one's position in spiritual life is nowhere. So because Nityananda is a Kanda Guru Tattva, one has to take his shelter in order to get Lord Chaitanya's shelter, and Lord Chaitanya's shelter in order to realize Radha and Krishna. In Prabhupada's purport, he explains in the purport to this song that the whole goal of the Krishna consciousness movement is to enter the dancing party of Radha and Krishna, the Rasalila dance. He said the same thing in a 1968 initiation ceremony in New Vrindavan, that this initiation ceremony is an opportunity so that one day or one life will be able to enter that dancing party. And this, he says here in this song, is gotten by the mercy of Nityananda. Anyone who does not take shelter of Nityananda, he must, as an alternative, take his shelter in material sukh, in material happiness and distress. But by taking shelter of Nityananda, he automatically becomes free from all attachment to material pleasures and pains. Anyone who doesn't take shelter of Nityananda, Narottam Das Thakur says he's like an untamed animal. Even though he has two legs, not four, still he is dvipada pashu, a two-legged animal. And as an animal cannot understand spiritual life, so one who is out of the contact of Nityananda Prabhu cannot have any understanding. So Narottam Das is concluding the song by saying, I'm very unhappy because I'm attached to material sukh and dukh, or material pleasures and pains. So your lotus feet are nitya, charana nitya, satya, and the highest truth. Prabhupada explains that no one should think that Nityananda's feet, taking shelter of them, is like taking shelter of anything in this material world. Anything that we take shelter of is explained by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami as a stone boat. If you try to ride in a stone boat, you know what happens. You immediately sink. Or if you grab the tail of a dog who's trying to swim across the ocean, you also sink. A dog can paddle a few feet, that's all, but impossible to swim across the ocean. So taking shelter of anything material is like taking shelter of a stone boat or a dog that's trying to swim. So no one should think, Narottam Das Thakur says, that by taking shelter of Nityananda's lotus feet, it's like that. It's not. His feet are satya and nitya. They're eternal and true. Just as
even today we can take shelter.
Hmm?
Even today.
Because today is within eternity. So Just as his name is Nityananda, eternal happiness, his lotus feet are also full of eternal happiness. And just as if you touch electricity, you become electrocuted. So if by touching Nityananda's lotus feet, because they are Nityananda, eternally full of happiness, that person also becomes eternally happy. So Narottam concludes by saying, O Lord Nityananda, I'm most unhappy in this world, so please make me happy by placing me at a corner of your lotus feet.
Very good.
Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna.
Nama Shrestham Manumati, Sache Putramatra Sarupam, Rupam tasya gajaburi purim madhurim gostavatim Radha kundam girivar maho radhika madhavasam Prapto yasya satita kripaya si gurum tam nadosham Vancha kalpa tarubhyasya Krikasindho bhaye vacha Patitanam pavanevikro Vaishnavetro Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradaya Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Gaurasthishena Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Tadalaya Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tada Bhaktaya Namo Bhaktya Vihinaya Paradha Lakshe Chiktasya Kamadi Taranga Madhyai Kripamayin Tvam Sharanam Prapanna Vrinde Numaste Charanar Bindam Vrinde Numaste Tavaivasmi, najivami tvaya vina iti vidhyay radhe tangnay maam vichya. Third chapter. We are explaining who is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and how and why he came to this world. He has told Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sachinandan Gaudhari, is himself Krishna, Swayam Krishna, not only Bhagavan, Swayam Bhagavan, Brajendanandan Krishna. And Krishna is always with all his attributes, all power, in the shape of Srimati Radhika. Sun can be separated from his heat and rays, but Radha and Krishna cannot be separated. He has played in Vrindavan for 10 years taking birth in Gokul, playing 2.5 years in Mahapan Gokul, and after that he came to Vrindavan, played so many pastimes. After that he went to near Radhakund, Shyamkund, and after that he went to Kamyavan, Khelanvan, and again he reached to his old destination, that is Nandagaon, Vashan. Meeting all this, doing Rash, best leader, pastime of Krishna, even since worldly there. Krishna always playing in Golok Vrindavan with his whole braj, whole associates, Jamuna, Govardhan, Mandirvan, Vrindavan, all 84 crores of Vrindavan. He took from Golok Vrindavan and brought with him in this earth. He takes only one time in each Brahma, one day. He played so much, he tested so many ras, Shant Vatsalya, Shant Dasa Sakha Vatsalya all. But three his wishes could not be fulfilled. And also he was so causeless merciful, full of mercy, and ocean of rush, that he wanted to give something as park or sprinkle to these jivas, that they should come forever to Krishna and Tusha. In the meantime, the time of Yugadharma came, and also Advaitacharya was thinking, he came first to make platform of coming Krishna and his associates. He wanted to give some prem, but he could not, because this is not the function of Mahavishnu or anyone, even to Ram, Nrisimha, Kalki, Vaman, Parshuram. Only Krishna can bestow his Krishna prem, braj prem to anyone. All the avatars can establish yuga dharma, the dharma of yuga, but they cannot give mercy like Krishna. They cannot give plants, animals, creepers, anyone that prem. Krishna can give it. Baldev Prabhu can, but he does not. Never does it. He kept reserved for Krishna. And he helps. Also in the pastime of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda could have done, but he never does. Yes. He is always waiting for Krishna. So, about four reasons. First, to establish Yuga Dharma. Second, Advaitacharya was calling at that time with Tulasi. If we are not able to worship Krishna and to please Krishna, by one method we can do, that Krishna will be pleased. This is, Krishna is not pleased by anything, so many devotions. Take very soft lips of Tulasi with Manjari in the middle. and offer praying, weeping. Krishna cannot live. He will have to leave his Golok Vrindavan and at once come. So we all devotees try to worship Tulasi, but try to do like Advaitacharya. Otherwise, they may not be here. So we should try to do daily life of Advaitacharya. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, all will come and come in our hearts. So, actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sachinandan Gaudhari, is himself Krishna. Nityananda Prabhu is himself Baladev Prabhu. Having the mode of doing kirtan through kirtan, Jugadhar, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu restored his Braja Prem to all living entity. Even to Krishna could not have done in the forest, serpents, elephants, tigers, she-goats, everyone began. So inspired with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That kirtan was Krishna Dasha. Krishna, 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 Krishna. Krishna, 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 Krishna. Ratchama, Pahima, Rama Raghava, Rama Raghava. And by doing kirtan, he was not in his senses. Tears coming, sometimes going down. And all elements, animals, creepers, trees, everyone was inspired. They began to follow what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was the Mahaprabhu and the teacher. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu give the rare to Brahma and Shankar, Uddhava and Narad, that Braj Prem he get distributed. All who came in the sight of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Krishna was merciful, no doubt, merciful. But he used to give Krishna Prem according to the quality of the devotees, like
balance,
taking him in balance, up to what quality their surrender and devotion is there, practice is there. Krishna used to give only like this, doing in a scale. Not less, not more.
Less, same quantity.
Understand?
Yes.
Krishna never gave pot to them. Or bring your pot. As your pot will be, I will give you that. Pot means disqualification. Without qualification, Krishna will not give. If you have so much offenses, he will not do. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu, so merciful, so merciful. They have no scale at all, no use of it. So those who are coming in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sachinandan Gaurav, because they are the son of Sachinandan, Sachi Devi, so merciful. So without a scale, he's coming, oh, come on, you have pot? No, I have no pot. No qualities. Oh, I'm giving you also pot and this nectar also. We have seen that so many that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given this. To giving It is secondary. No? To give him this prem is also secondary. To chant and to do kirtan is also yuga dharma. This was the deity of Mahavishnu. But Vishnu, Mahavishnu can establish yuga dharma, but not he can give Krishna. And Krishna tested the three boats of Srimati Radhika. It was his own
desire
and his own mood he wanted. This mood, except Krishna, anyone cannot test. Radha only can test, and Krishna borrowed the mood, interior mood of Radhika and beauty, and he became Tadatma to Srimati Radhika. Tadatma means? Observe. Oneness to Radha, Tadatma. Like fire becomes Tadatma in iron at sea burns. Iron does not burn. The power of fire burns. There she has become Tadatma with iron. So, likewise, Krishna became Tadatma with Radhika. He became she Radhika. He forgot that I am Krishna. Actually, when he met Rayaraman in
Godavari,
and he learnt everything from Vishakha, she was Vishakha. And Krishna made Guru to Vishakha to have the mood and beauty of Krishna. Then Krishna became Mahabhava Rasarashwar. Otherwise he could not have. He took Srimati Vishakha as his Guru. And then he took this mood. And then he tested all these three modes in Gambhira at Jagannath. Otherwise he could not have done that. So he is very kritagya, grateful to Vishakha Lalita. Without their help, Krishna could not have this thing. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, being Krishna, he can distribute his Braj Prem. Especially in Braj Prem, Parakiya Bhav. It is called Unnata Ujjvala Rasa. Unnat means highest. Ujjvala Rasa means very shining. Very shining. Rasa. Rasa, being a rasa, it is so shining. Unparalleled, there is no equal to that. So our all the acharyas have come for this. Not to test three things, but to give what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So this is main but not supreme reason. Second, first is to test Radha mood, and second is to sprinkle, distribute the rare prem for Brahma and Shankar and Nara to Jivas. This is Krishna duty, and Krishna power or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu mantra. So all acharyas, Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Jiva Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, Krishna Das Kaviraj, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Shyamananda Prabhu, Nattam Thakur, Srinivasa Acharya, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Paladevi Vidyabhushan, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Srila Prabhupada, Srila Bhakti Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshava Goswami Maharaj, Swami Maharaj. They have not only come to preach name. It can be preached by the associate of Mahavishnu also. They can do. Understand, try to understand. But it can be preached by the associates of Mahaprabhu. Mahavishnu, Advaita Acharya. Even they can preach. But they cannot preach Braj Prem through Nam Prem Sankirtan. There is so much a difference in Nam Sankirtan of all other Kali Yuga and this Kali Yuga. Dvaitacharya and his associates can establish Nam Sankirtan, Yuga Dharma. But by Nam Sankirtan they cannot give this prem which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to give. This is a speciality of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his followers, his associates. Associates of Mahavishnu, Sanak Sanandan Sanatan, Vishwaksen, all the associates of Vishnu, they can do Nam Sankirtan. Establish also that thing. But that Nam Sankirtan will not give Krishna Prem Vaishnava. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his says Nam Sankirtan has a special power. By this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, through Nam Sankirtan he gave what?
Prem.
That Braja Prem. Even that Prem, what? Unnata Ujjala Arvasa. Unnat Ujjal Arash is the mood of especially Srimati Radhika. It cannot be given. Krishna can taste. He cannot give. Mahaprabhu cannot give. They can taste it oneself, himself. What he gave? It was also Unnat Ujjal Arash. Unnat Ujjal Arash is of two kinds. No? Kamatmika and tat tat bhav icchatmika. Kamatmika, the mood of Srimati Radhika, Lalita, Vishakha. All the aids and all others. These are kamatmika. Sakhis are four kinds. Sakhi, Nitya Sakhi, Pran Sakhi, Priya Sakhi, and Narva Sakhi. Again, Sakhi, Nitya Sakhi, Pran Sakhi, Priya Sakhi, and Priya Narva Sakhi. Among these Sakhi, Dhanishta is Sakhi. He is something bending towards Krishna, pleasing more Krishna. Nitya Sakhi and Pran Sakhi. Serving both Radha and Krishna, but somewhat bending towards Srimati Radhika, always with Radhika, doing everything to please Srimati Radhika. They don't care Krishna. If Krishna will call them, they will not obey. They will obey only Srimati. So, among them, those are most dear. These are Nitya Sakhi and Pran Sakhi. Among them, those who are most dearest, serving Radha and Krishna conjugal, but always a tendency, little tendency towards Srimati Radhika, not like solely bending towards Srimati Radhika. They are Priya Narvasakhi, they are Priyashakhi, Priya Narvasakhi. They are Lalita Abhishakhanda. Sometimes chastising Krishna, sometimes chastising Srimati Radhika. They have so much power. So there is a difference between this Nitya and Ramsakhi. They are like called Manjaris. They don't do anything for themselves. Always for Srimati Radhika. They don't want to test anything for themselves. This bhav is called Tattad Ichhatmika bhav. But yet it is Unnata Ujjvala. I am telling for very few rare persons. Very high topic. Why I am telling? I am explaining this shloka that anything, first object should be made. What is our object? Then sadhan will come. How to get it? We want money, then we will have to serve government, to do business, any kind of business. If you are not doing all, you can thief, you can
steal.
Even you are not expert in thieving, then be anishtasu, aristasu. Having swords with so many dacoits, make a group and attack gang and attack and take that thing forcibly. Or like Krishna, alone he attacked for Rukmini. He went to the kingdom of the father of Rukmini, Bhishma Puri. And there were lakhs and lakhs kings with soldiers, with full power. They were protecting Krishna not to come there. And to take Rukmini. But Krishna came as a lion, very on the group of jackals, and he took Rukmini on his chariot. And he flew to Dwarka. And there he married Rukmini. So if by begging anything, by stealing nothing is coming. Possibly. And by who can cring? By any means. Who can crook? Any means. He will take it. You know dogs? They standing on the soaps of Rasagulla and Malai. If anyone takes anything, they only see like this. Like this. No? Some water coming from there. And they are looking all this. But Dukanwala has some stick in his hand. So if anyone comes and takes Malai Rasagulla in the dona. And they do like this and then eagerly they go and they do. Seeing that other dogs should not come and do like this. Licking and licking. So, first object should be there, fixed. What is our object of our sadhana bhajan? What we want? And if it is fixed, then we will choose how to receive this thing. This is called sadhan, that is called sadhan. If anyone has no object at all of sadhan bhajan, he cannot decide his shravan means. So in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, first after Mangalacharanam slok, first he has given. What should be the object? Do you, your object is what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to give? That Braja Prem, Unnat Pujjal Bhav? Yes, I have some greed. Greed that, Lobha. Company. You should go to school of Rupa Goswami. And then you should read all these things. No? How to take it? There is no rule, regulation how this greed will come. Nothing. Forget it is not essential. Anything. Only to see anyhow. Or to hear. Great can come. But by Shastra, by arguments, it will not come great. Any very ordinary, there is a person, very ordinary, looking ugly, black, crooked, having no quality, no money, so ugly. But that person, if you see Dinah, you know? Dinah? Of England?
Dinah.
He may have some grit to make her wife. No tax, no wealth is needed, nothing for this greed. But actually to make her wife, oh, it is absurd. He can. But he may have greed, because greed has no control. So our greed may be by hearing, what hearing? Rupa Goswami books, Krishna beauty. And affection of the gopis towards Krishna, hearing. In Srimad Bhagavatam, how Krishna was controlled by gopis. He began to pray on the and to give his head on the feet of Srimati Radhika, praying. I want your pranay, I want your mercy. So by hearing all these things by Rupa Goswami's books from Chaitanya Charitamrita, a greed may come, whether you are qualified or not, does not matter. You are devotee or not devotee. But if this greed comes, then he becomes qualified to choose anything, any way, any means, and that is called Shadha. Then he becomes at once in the stage of Ruchi, galloping all these things. But those who are fearing from Shastra, and if you will not do no bhajan of Krishna, you will go to hell. So I must do bhajan of Krishna. This is called Vaidhi Bhakti is no? Vritti, Pravritti. Pravritti means by this Pravritti we can engage ourselves in the sadhana of Krishna Bhakti. And so this is called Vaidhi Pravritti. And that is called Raganuga Pravritti. Not Raganuga, but a greed towards Raganuga only. Ragaru, ragatmik is different. Gopis, mood is ragatmik. Those who are in this world having rag and they have reached up to mood of bhav, they are raganuga. And who has not reached anything, not doing, but they have greed, then they are qualified to be Raganuga. Not Raganuga yet, but they can be. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come only to give this greed. And those who had greed, to give bhav. And those who had bhav, to give prem. What to give? Not Radhamur, not Unnat Ujjal Kamatmik bhav. Understand? Understanding something? All will not understand. But try. After 10 years, 20 years, or in any other life, being in the society of very Unnat Vaishnava, you can realize something. I'm also trying to enter in this. I have that mood of greed. I want that. But I'm not Radhanuga. Actually, I'm not Radhanuga. I want that in any life, thousand of life, I may be the mercy of Radhanuga Vaishnava. But I hope something. I don't want anything other than this. Only this thing. Nothing else. I will die no harm. But I will not go to any other ghat. Ghat, you know?
Drinking place.
To drink water from any other place. Only in Keshi ghat. Harmanshi Ganga ghat. Only the ghat of gopis. That what kind of gopis? Tattade Ichhatmika Bhava gopis. So now I am going to explain the real sloka, mood sloka. Anarpita charin chirat karunaya avatirnah kalau samarpayitum unnuta janarsamsa bhakti sin hariha purata sundara durutika damba sandipita sadaridaya kandare spuratu me sachina. You can do meditation sachina then gauranga bolta hai mai aati aata ke pura dhate pa le এমন করতে করে যেতে পারে। There are so many good kirtans like this, but you cannot understand. Goranga Nahita, like other, there are kirtan, but it is very understandable by me. Goranga Nahita, or Goranga Nahita, ye samjhe? Goranga bolita hai bata.
Goranga bolite hame. Gaurang bolite hobe kolaka sarira hari hari mani tena ane bave
Thank you.
This is shlok which I uttered. This shlok has been written in Mangala Charana. Srila Rupa Goswami in his own book Vidarbha Madhava. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has inspired Rupa Goswami in Prayag.
that you should fulfill my wishes. Why I have come? To give and to practice my soul. Unnat Ujjal Parakhiya Bhav of Gopis. Unparalleled. Even in Golok Vrindavan, what to tell of this world? You should also see that this frame is our Nitya Dharma, eternal religion of all entity, living entity, not only of persons. Someone loved anyone, any lady or person. They were married, loving each other. But anyone of them saw that my wife is not solely loving me, but to another person. He'll be upset. Or if wife is saying that my husband is not loving me, but internally he loves anyone, then he will be upset. Their whole life will be upset. Not only in this world, to men only and women. Everywhere there are relation of wife or husband and loved and beloved, even in creatures, creepers, trees, animals. Without this loving, they cannot. Huh?
They cannot live.
They cannot live. Also, trees and creepers have this affection, but they cannot express. We can express to extent, some extent. Where this prem is through this body, material body, to satisfy these bodies. This prem is what? This is called kaam and this is not pure.
Lust.
This is called lust and it will always give pain and suffering. So many problems. We think that, and we see that in whole world this problem is there. Each person, those who have lust for each other, they cannot be satisfied. If man cannot satisfy fully any woman. Woman cannot satisfy. This satisfaction only come if we have some affection to Krishna. Otherwise, anyone cannot be satisfied. After 1 month, 2 months, 1 day, 2 days, 4 days, he will be not satisfied and he will see another. We are culprit and we have been driven from that and we have come to this only in jail. This is like a jail. We are all refugees. So how we can be without problem? So Krishna has arranged to test more sufferings and more problems he has created. That go to this world and test. You are seeking lust in wives, in husbands, in children, in mother, father, in friends, in worldly things. You will like it. They will create problems, problems and problems. Ram has also come to teach these things. He came with his own Lakshmi, Sita Devi, to play a role, to teach worldly he was. Went in one jungle, forest, with Lakshman and
Sita Devi.
What to teach? Lust is very bad thing. Sometimes husband becomes controlled by wife's lust. And what he is doing is neglectful. Marriage came in the shape of
deer, golden deer.
No? Sita. Saw it. Rama controlled by Sita. He is showing. Sita told, I want this deer. You can catch it living, or you can
shoot it
and bring his skins. Lakshman, one thing, don't follow this deer. This deer is not real deer. Any demon, and will be put in troubles and so many problems. Don't go. Disobey your wife. I'm warning. But Rama was so controlled to show others. He was not controlled. He is himself Krishna, Bhagavan. So he is not under Maya, but he is showing that if you are controlled like this, the effect will be these problems. Yes, I should do. I must do. Carry the order of my wife. If he is demon, no hurt. If he is anything, no hurt. He went, and what was the result, you know? Problems to last. What problem? Ram has to left Sita two times. You know that? He left Sita first.
Ever.
At the last. Only that he was with Ravan some days. She was pure, but even all were in doubt. Sita is pure or not pure. So Ram has to follow that. He was lusty, but yet standing in the jungle forest, she was repenting. He was in what? In Raj Palace. Raj Palace? See?
Royal Palace.
But Sita was in forest, in the ashram of Valmiki, sleeping on the mats of grasses, in jungle, cutting the woods for making cooking. Nothing there like palace. Ram was repenting. I have sent Sita. But I should also don't take any test, anything. He gave up all these things. He used to be alone in his palace, sitting, sleeping on the floor on mat. Sita has need.
Sleep.
She can easily sleep. But Ram cannot. She lay. I have done mistake. I have gone to satisfy my praja, my
subjects.
I have done wrong. She lay. Always weeping. Valmiki was there to
console
Sita. But Ram has none who will
give consolation.
No one to remove his
wife's tears.
If he'll know the heart of Ram, he will also be bitter. What became at last? Ram has some yajna. Anywhere on the bank of a river Gomti, near Naimisharanya, all the subjects, mothers, monkeys, Hanuman, Sugriv, Vibhishan, Ram, Lakshman, Bharat, Lakshman, Shatrughna, all mothers, Kaikeyi, Kausalya, all were assembled there. And sacrifice was Ashwamedh Yagya, not Ashwamedh, Rajasu Yagya was done. In the morning up to 10, Yagya was going on. And after that, in the middle period, midday, all is to assemble and to hear Puranas, Katha. One day, Lokus came in that Sabha, assembly. There were very beautiful boy as Ram was. Both were twin brothers. Coming at once from home. Age about 8 or 9. Very beautiful. Resembling fish like Ram. But no one knows that from where they have come and who are they. And they took Veena in their hands and began to recite Valmiki Ramayana. Very beautifully, so marvelous tune, Murchana and Aroha, Aroha, you know?
Up and down.
Sounds going so high in Karuna Ras. Karuna Ras means? Karuna Ras?
Lamentation.
And again can trembling, trembling. No. Like in Veena comes. That thought was so sweet. All were hearing pin drop silence. The scene was that they were singing from Ayodhya, Ram, Lakshman and Sita are by the order of Kaikeyi. They are living in Dava and Ajit. Dasarath was lamenting so much. And he told Haram, Haram, and died at once. In the shape of Sannyasi, they three went. All their weeping there. So when they were describing and singing, pin drop silence was there. All were moved and all were weeping. The boys were also weeping. They were not weeping. But Ram, Lakshman, Bharat, Kaikeyi, Kausalya, Hanuman, Sugriv, and all the audience were weeping by hearing. As if Ram is actually going. That day, it became late for them. Ram sent Lakshman, go and ask them, who is the father of this boy? And from where they have come? And give this donation, a pot, golden pot, full of golden coins. So many Rashmi cloths, Rashmi silk. With gold ornaments. Lakshman came down from the throne and called the two boys. My dear boys, can you tell who is the father? Who is your father? The father's name? And from where you are coming? Your dignification? What?
Dignification.
I did. I know, I want to know. Ram once don't. They became silent and told. You know that Vedas you have read, you are learning person. To Brahmachari and Sannyasi, one should not ask the father and mother of the Brahmachari and Sannyasi, you don't know?
this etiquette and asking my father, you are that I am from this and we are two Brahmin Charis. Oh yes, we are the disciple of Bali. And from there we are coming. He has learned these things. He became wordless. And he was ashamed. Oh yes, they are telling right. So you should not ask the father name, mother where, or Maharaj, you are married, your wife is still there, your sons or daughters are there, to Brahmacharis. Don't ask the name of father and mother. Maybe you can ask from whom? Your guru, what is the name of your guru? Where is your ashram? You can ask. Only this, not anything. And ask Harikatha. So Lakshman was astonished and ashamed. But he told that, very good, but we want to donate something to you. This boat in this golden pot, so many jewels were there, alankar. Ornaments are there. They replied, what is this use of? For Brahmachari? We cannot take it. We are simply Brahmacharis. We take fruits and it is efficient in an offering in our ashram. No need of taking any patra, no vessel or anything. We take water from. Nothing. It is not no use of us. Please return it to Ram. He is king and he has so many things to do. We have nothing to do with all these things. And they returned. When they returned to their mother, mother was waiting. Why today it became so late? She asked, she took this boy in his arms, this one, and begin to in right and left sides. Oh, sons, why you make late? They answered, today, mother, we went very far away in the council of any king. They don't know name and anything. And there we were singing. I don't know why all were sleeping. All. The king was also his brothers and even monkeys and
deer.
Deer. Are in a young one.
Bear.
Also sleeping. But I, oh mother, I see very strange thing there. What? That there was a golden statue. Oh, fully lighting. You are
talking,
but she was not talking. But same thing, same mouth, same all beauty, everything. Sita began to leave his turn. Was that time? Mother, why you are meeting? And doing like this. Why? But what Sita can tell? Because Ram has the same Ram. He could not tell anything. Anyhow, next day, Ram asked Valmiki, bring Sita at once. I know that Sita is with you. I know. Bring Sita. Without Sita, I cannot. He brought next day Sita coming, two boys like this, his fingers hand in hand, boys sing in ground, and he was silently coming
following Pali. All that Pindar's disciples in party will be. Rama is eagerly saying, Lakshman, Hanuman, Kausalya, Smita, all were eagerly saying. Who is this girl to pass? It seems that, oh Sita, so must be the son of Rama. Otherwise they cannot be so beautiful. When Sita came nearer, Ram asked Sita, I want a proof that you are pure. Sita told very honorably, mildly, yet you are wanting any proof? We have not received any good proofs by Dasarath Maharaj, by Paman Dev, by Fire Dev. They have not told you? Yes, I am getting any proof. And he prayed like this. He told, O Mother Earth, you are my mother. At once he should be divided in
two
and take me in your lives. If I don't know anyone other than Ram, my heart has not touched anyone for moment, ex-second. And you see that I am pure, at once you should give me your life. Yes, she told Balli three times, at once. With a sound, earth was divided. Very golden, very beautiful golden chariot came at once. And Prithvi Devi took in his arms Sita Devi on his lap. And at once, earth was
closed.
Ram at once jumped. Sita, Sita, Sita. And began to cry. You have done leaving me? Oh, my sister, mother-in-law, Prithvi. So my Sita, otherwise I will
suck
it. And I will do in pieces. At once I got it. Ball making, at once came and
stop.
Stop there, go down. Don't be loved. Now Sita has gone there and she is waiting there. So what these are? Only it was lust for Ram, showing to world, and don't do like this. If you want to be happy, you should try to attain pure love affection for Krishna. Don't do me like this. Other problems from the old world begin. So we should think that this praying is our
property,
our swabhavik nitya dharma. We'll have to achieve if we want to be happy forever. Don't create nonsense things by lust and all these things. If you are married, no heart. Treat your wife as Krishna Priya. Sir, and try to be together with love and affection. But that real and affection should be reserved for Krishna. Do your duty only to practice bhakti yoga, to be with her, or your children, or with wealth. They are not bad, but try to उनका उपयोग अच्छा होना चाहिए प्रॉपर ट्राई टू प्रॉपर यूज लाइक डोंट थिंक दैट दे आर लाइक ऑलवेज फॉर लस्ट मनली टू गेन समथिंग फॉर मी डस मेक इट प्रॉपर यूज एंड मेक इट लाइक Vaikunth here in this world and practice bhakti yoga. It is all for practice. It is this. This is a school like
training center.
You should take center training here. Don't be involved. Otherwise, it will be make so much problems. Now, I will begin of this sloka. I have only told that lust is another thing. And Krishna, pure Krishna Premi is another thing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to give this eternal dharma.
Religion.
He has come here. He has descended to this world. So we should not khona nahi chahiye that
media.
We should not waste this very opportunity, good opportunity. In this very life, from today, we should practice bhakti yoga. Being in the association of pure devotees, where there is no politics, hypocrisy, duplicity, democracy. See, out of all these things, try to be in the association. Today, this, again, tomorrow, I will explain this, the real and deeper meaning of this issue. This is like a
platform.
I'm so happy. I'm indebted to you that you have come to see, to hear all these things. I'm also fortunate to tell you this. I should not tell you, it is very secret thing. I'm very high. But if I will not tell, any one of you cannot tell. So if any one of you are taking this thing, what I am telling, I will think that I am letting you. If 1,000 parts, one part, among 1,000 parts, you will take one part, then also I am satisfied. Because if a greed comes, One kirtan. Any kirtan you like. After this, we can do aarti, kirtan and prahar distribution.
Thank you. to Arpit and give the prasadam to all.
Vaishnav Dakoshala Bhakti.
Here he comes, he's going to walk by the front door.
Just open the door. Where do you get close to the box? That's how they spread it.